Welcome to Sakaraha, Madagascar. I've come here to the southern sapphire bearing region with a number of my colleagues in order to teach the local people the basics of field gemology. We'll be taking over 60 students, and over the next 6 days we'll be teaching them simple techniques like how to use a loop, how to use tweezers. We're doing some gem ID using things like dichroism and crystal shape. We'll also be showing them some basic ways of how to identify both synthetic and artificial stones. Then we will give them a little bit of information on geology and some simple mining techniques. But lastly, and most importantly, we'll also be giving them information on how to effectively grade their stones, thus giving them a way to actually get a fair price for the stones they're trying to sell. Our journey took us to the townships of Sakaraha, Mahabuka, and Baliki Umbanani. We were welcomed with enthusiasm and a keen interest to learn more about the trade that sustains their communities. The local people here derive much of their daily means from small-scale artisanal mining. The mining process is usually conducted on two fronts. Firstly, there are those that dig the gravel, either from small, deep holes where they will dig laterally when they hit the gravel, or once the gem-bearing gravel is found, they may open up the hole into a small pit. Once the gravel is recovered, it is taken to a local water source where it is poured into a handheld shaker so that the material can be cleaned. Once this is done, the gravel is then painstakingly sifted through by hand. We hope in the future to be able to help develop more effective recovery methods that have a lower environmental impact and can be supplied to local miners at little to no cost on their behalf. At 9 a.m, our students would shuffle in and we would get started for the day. Each person was provided with a toolkit and a handbook specially developed by Lawson Gems to cater for the very low literacy levels in Madagascar. The book was shown in parallel on a projector, and with the aid of our fantastic translator Jasmine, we were able to effectively convey the course. The course was also aimed at being very practical, with constant demonstrations of the techniques and theories they were learning. This even included the students learning how to build their own dichroscope. Now once they have done that, they can take the two pieces and they can look for... The full kit they each received included the course book, a 10x loop, gem tweezers, gem grabber, waterproof torch, gem scoop, a selection of resealable plastic bags, a white plastic bowl, and a handmade capillana fabric bag in which to carry it all. The proper technique for handling a loop and tweezers was heavily stressed in order to give them a professional air when dealing with stones. We also encouraged members within the class to aid in teaching their classmates once they had mastered the techniques themselves.
You can see nice, perfect half circle, half sphere.
Student demonstrations were also encouraged, but not only were locals used to help demonstrate, we also enlisted the aid of our talented gem cutter, Tahiri Kamara, And again, a very hands-on approach was taken. It must also be said that outside the classroom, we also met many interesting characters.
Já sabi ni já ti safira boca ma aito ikara zambat mas pis pela pes.
With the classes at an end, we made our way back to Antananarivo. Here, we were fortunate enough to be given the opportunity to present, along with GIZ, in front of the Women's National Council of Madagascar. This was a great opportunity, and we felt it definitely got the wheels turning within high society of Madagascar, with a strong focus on women in need in the industry. The organisation behind our project was the German-based GIZ. They've been doing fantastic work in Madagascar, and within our field, we were especially excited to see the mine site rehabilitation they were organising. Over the course of our expedition, we had the chance to meet some wonderful people and see some amazing scenes. But nothing was more encouraging than seeing the enthusiasm and willingness to learn shown by the Malagasy people. Hopefully, it won't be long before we can get back there and help keep the fight going for greater equality for the promising people of Madagascar.
Sofé, sofé, triple fé! Merci, dude.